For many years, mankind have tamed nature. Its innovative ideas led it to be top dog. But it was only until the 1700s that it conquered pain with aspirin. It started with a clergyman named Edward Stone when he read a paper to the Royal Society of London called An Account of the Success of the Bark of the Willow in the Cure of the Elves. These papers date back to 460 BC,
Copernicus,
Poseidon, left by Hippocrates.
Olympus.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
I'm here to view some documents. Thank you very much.
I'm here at the Royal Institute in London to see Edmund Stone's original manuscript on the treatment of inflammation with willow bark.
Hello, Professor Clark.
Now, the document is over here, but before that, I must ask that you wear some special gloves.
Okay.
This is a very old document.
How old is it?
It's almost 150 years.
Wow.
It's very old.
You know, you shouldn't trust me with kind of stuff.
No. With the special gloves, it should be fine.
Okay.
There should be no...
And if there was any damage,
how much
would that cost me?
Oh, it would be priceless.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Is this here?
Yes, it's right here.
Here it is. I'm just going to go and take it to one of the reading areas. Okay. Be careful not to damage the very old paper. An account of the suckles of the bark of the willow in the cure of agues, in a letter to the Right Honourable George Earl of Macclesfield, President of RS, from the Reverend Mr. Edmund Stone of Chipping Norton in Oxfordshire. Ah, and here it says about...
There is a bark of an English tree which delights in moist wax oil, where args, which is blend, is chiefly abound. And later on it says how brownies lie not far from their causes.
But it wasn't until the 1830s that Scottish physicians realised that willow could have other uses. Okay. This physician found that willow bark extracts also relieve symptoms of acute rheumatism, so perhaps it could be further developed. It also smells funny.
But it wasn't until the 1840s, when organic chemists working with willow bark and the meadow plant spirea, managed to isolate the key chemical that creates aspirin today.
The base ingredient is salicin, and the word salix means willow in Latin.
In 1870, Professor von Nenke of Basel had an innovative thought, which took the idea of salicin and showed how the body converted into salicylic acid, which, as every chemist knows, is 2-hydroxybenzoic acid. The acid was then created and used to help patients with fever and their symptoms.
Water. Don't mean willow!
Unfortunately, many of the patients then developed stomach problems due to adverse side effects. What happened was, when salicylic acid was taken directly, it caused severe irritation of the lining of the mouth, gullet, and even the stomach.
But then in 1875, a group of chemists made sodium salicylate, or sodium 2-hydroxybenzoate. Then they asked some doctors to test it on some patients.
Now, this time the irritation was less, but unfortunately the taste was disgusting. Especially the large doses for treating rheumatism. This caused the patient to vomit.
Doctor, capitalist pig, shoot me in the leg!
Okay, don't fight.
I need painkiller!
Don't fight, I didn't know.
Oh,
wonderful. It's some blue.
What is it called?
I don't know. Try it. Nobody bothered to tell me anything.
This tastes like shit! What are you feeding me?
But then in the 1890s, German chemist
Felix Hoffman from the Bayer Company managed to create a drug with good medicinal properties, low membrane irritation, and...
Doctor, thank you for saving my leg, but lab coat is too small.
This is how you are driving?
Sorry.
And now all you do is complain. Gary, we are a great budget.
Okay, I will go and live in my hole now.
Yes, go do that. I am busy.
Using salicylic acid, Hoffman had created aspirin. A name being derived from the soil plant, which is a large amount of salicylic acid naturally.
Finally, in 1898, Hoffman managed to complete clinical trials of the drug, manufacture it, and eventually patent it. But this was just a start to what would be a revolutionary drug. During the First World War, the British wanted aspirin to help out their troops. Unfortunately, the Germans were the only ones manufacturing it.
The British then decided to offer 20,000 pound rewards to anyone that could working manufacture a product. A pharmacist in Melbourne called George Nicholas came up with the idea.
It was also used in the Spanish flu pandemic in 1918, but research does suggest that aspirin could have been the cause of the high death. In 1917, Bayer's patent on the manufacturing of aspirin expired. Because of the high popularity of aspirin at the time, many companies were in fierce competition, meaning many aspirin brands were created.
But it wasn't until a long time after Bayer's discovery that they actually realized how aspirin really works. Essentially, let's imagine that Matt has been cut, so he's got like an area of pain, like here, yeah? This is the area of pain. And what happens is, white blood cells, they come along to the area of pain and they start like leading all these complicated chemical reactions and like to heal the area. But as a side effect, this enzyme called COX, it creates prostaglandins, well, a type of prostaglandins, because some of them are good, some of them are bad, but they make a certain type of prostaglandin which causes inflammation, essentially, so we get prostaglandins coming out here. And that's what causes the pain and inflammation. But what aspirin does is it blocks the COX inhibitor. It essentially, you know, kills the enzyme. The enzyme's called COX, so you could describe aspirin as a COX blocker. But see, another problem we have with aspirin is that there are two types of COX. There's COX 1, which is the one responsible for creating the prostaglandins which cause inflammation and pain. But there's also COX 2. Yeah? And COX 2 is responsible for creating the prostaglandin which creates the lining of the stomach and also makes the blood coagulate to stop, you know, bleeding forever, essentially. And that's how aspirin can also reduce heart attacks, because no blood clots can develop in the blood because it's all being, it can't be coagulated because of COX-2 being inhibited. But that's a problem as well, because COX-2, the inhibition of COX-2 means that the lining in your stomach is going to not be there, and you can actually suffer a really intense internal bleeding, and you can actually die from that as well. So that's how aspirin works, but today, they're developing a new line of drugs that inhibit COX-2, that inhibit COX-1 alone, but keeps COX-2 working. That doesn't have the same heart attack reducing effect, but it still reduces pain and inflammation. And now, over two centuries on from the discovery of the Willis effect, over 10 million kilograms of aspirin is manufactured in the US each year alone, and 40,000 tons are consumed each year worldwide. And aspirin isn't only good for pain relief, but it also has been linked to prevention of heart disease. Which means that aspirin is very good for your mind and your body.
Hoffman had today. Aspirin. Since salicylic acid alone, Hoffman had isolated key ingredients.
It's not only good for pain relief and anti-inflammation. Aspirin isn't only good for pain relief, it's also
Oh, that is rubbish.
Because, the cox is an enzyme which creates this no blood clots forming the arteries and veins, which naturally cause heart disease. Which means that aspirin is very good for your really good for your mind and body.
Although aspirin does have some side effects, what happened to my face? Although it does have some side effects, it's perfectly good for the mind and body. And I don't see why I can't pop a couple more. Gee, perfectly harmless.
Yeah, sir, what are you doing over there? It looks like a bunch of complicated hibbledygook to me.
Reason? You do not understand this? Because you are the leader of the Russian dog!
Sir, I find you very insulting. In fact, I cannot put up with your racism anymore. I'm leaving. And you will never see me again. I quit!
You racist pig!
Racist pig! Asshole! Asshole!
You are an
asshole!
Idiot. This is my
you should have your head!
Lucky Park.
Your mother was an umpster, and your father, he smelled of elderberries.
Okay. All that is rubbish.